So, the first idea that I want to reflect upon, and I won't be too lengthy here, but the first idea I want to reflect upon is about Rahma. And the first part that I wanted to think about specifically, because again, we've heard the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it says, a great month has come to you, talking about Ramadan. And what does he say? Awwaluhu Rahma. The beginning of it is mercy. Wa awsatuhu maghfirah. And the middle of it is forgiveness. Wa akhiruhu rijhukum min an-nar. And the end of it is freedom from the hellfire. And we know that when Allah shows somebody mercy, what does He do? He forgives that person. And when Allah forgives somebody, He frees them from the hellfire. So these are ideas that we'll be hearing in the khutbah in the next few weeks, in the conversations and the lectures. And there are ideas that we should be reflecting upon. And we should never have this attitude like, oh, I heard that already. It's a problem in our community now, like, oh, I heard that hadith. I got news for you. There's not going to be new hadith. Right? Oh, I don't know that ayah. That's played out. We don't have it on the character traits of God. Now, obviously, there are realities about Allah and attributes of Allah that are unattainable by anybody except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when he says, take on the akhlaq, literally the character traits, the ways of being of Allah, it means to the extent that it's humanly possible, because obviously we can't become Allah. It means to take on certain attributes, like justice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just. So we should take on justice as an attribute that we imbibe and that we translate in our dealings with other people. We should be just in everything that we do. Allah is forbearing, meaning even though He may be displeased or He may be angered, He doesn't just destroy people. Right? If Allah were to take people to account for what they do, He wouldn't have left a single creature on the face of the earth. We know that. So He's Aleem. He's Wadud. He's all-loving, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are attributes that we're supposed to take on. But think about the fact that Allah, at the beginning of every chapter in the Qur'an, reminds us of Rahman and Rahim. Rahman and Rahim. Over and over and over again. So mercy is one of the things that we should really, really try to embody. Now, there's a difference between Rahman and Rahim, as you know. Rahman is absolute, total mercy. What's called al-Rahmah al-Mutlaqa. It's total, it's endless, boundless mercy. And in that regard, everything and everyone is included in that mercy. And this is why one of the great imams, he saw shaitan. He met the devil. Some of us have met the devil too, we just didn't know it was the devil. So he meets shaitan, and he says to him, كيف حالك? How are you? He said, أنا في رحمة الله. I'm in Allah's mercy. He said, how could you be in Allah's mercy? وأنت شيطان. And you're shaitan. He said, didn't Allah say, ورحمتي وسعت كل شيء? وأنا شيء. He said, didn't Allah say, my mercy has enveloped everything? He said, I'm a thing. But then Allah says what? وسأكتبها للذين يتقون. But I will specify that mercy for those who have piety. So this is what they call Rahmatul Ijad, the mercy of being able to exist. Think about that. Allah didn't even have to create us. Subhanallah. Like, you didn't have to exist. And if you didn't exist, the show wouldn't have, like Lupe said, the show goes on, right? It would have kept going. It wouldn't have ended just because you weren't there. Like, you know, yeah, the world just wouldn't be the same without me. No, it would have been going right along. And when Nabi Atiyah even said, إِنُّ مِنَ دَعْلِ لَمْ يُكُنْ شَيْئًا أَذْكُورًا, didn't it occur to a human being a period of time when he was something completely unmentioned? He wasn't even talked about. Now, so Rahman is absolute mercy, and then Rahim is a specific type of mercy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a specific mercy to the people who believe in Him. But think about when Allah talks about Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what does He say about that mercy? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً. Huh? Think about that for a second. We did not send you except as a mercy to whom? To the Arabs? I mean, He could have said, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ رَحْمَةً لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. He didn't say that, but He could have said, we sent you as a mercy to the Muslims. Or, we sent you to as a mercy to the Muslims from such and such place. We did not send you as except as a mercy لِلْعَالَمِينَ, to everything. Now, obviously, there's extensive commentary from the Mufassirin about what specifically al-alami means. But the point is here that when Allah talks about the mercy embodied in a human being, He talks about it as a mercy that was basically boundless. Remember that hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he kisses Imam al-Hasan, and the Bedouin man sees him do that, and he says, "I have 11 children, and I've never kissed any of them." What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Whoever doesn't show mercy will not be shown mercy. Because he did such and such time. You know, one time this person said or did such and such to me, I'll never forgive them. And now you have a person who doesn't show mercy will not be shown mercy. So you say, there's no way I can forgive this brother. Why? Because he did such and such. What if Allah says in the day of judgment, there's no way I can forgive this person. Why? The dude looked at the haram, ate the haram, walked to the haram, took from the haram, said the haram, listened to the haram. There's no way. There's no way because you're wrong. And what are you going to say in the day of judgment? You're going to, you know, advocate for yourself. Today, we'll seal their mouths. And their hands are going to speak to us. And their feet will testify. Against them, bearing testimony to that which they did. So there's going to be no conversation. So if you want to have mercy shown to you, show it to other people. And just sit down for a minute and think about how big is it? Can you just let it ride? And I'm not talking about cases of abuse and those type of things. You know, there's a place for forgiveness even in that context. But just think about it. Do we really need to not forgive one another? May Allah forgive us all the other. And the second part of Ramadan is forgiveness. Ghafara, as you know, in the Arabic language, comes from a word that means to cover something up. It means to cover it up. So when Allah, the Prophet says at the beginning of Ramadan is mercy, we should come into the month with just thinking about as much mercy as we can possibly have. Mercy toward one another, mercy toward our spouses. And one of the important ways of doing that is being easy on one another. If the brother comes home and says, look, things are kind of tight, I'm kind of having a hard time, be merciful with that. Be merciful. Don't be like, you need to do what you need to do. You know, Allah's merciful, I'll be right. Be merciful, you know? His wife is like, she's like, honey, I'm really tired today. Look, you better get up in that kitchen. You better get your guitar on, okay? I need some chorus. Make that check. Be merciful. Be merciful. And to your children as well. Wallahi, be merciful to your children. I was telling the Shabbat over here, I can't even imagine what it must be like to be a young person and be Muslim in today's world. I can't even imagine that. And I work with young people and I know the stuff that they're going through. I can't even imagine that. So be merciful to them. Be merciful to your children. And children, be merciful to your parents as well. And realize they're doing the best that they can. So we have to think about how we can be merciful to as many people as we can in as many ways as we can. And then try to be forgiven. May Allah, I want to leave time for reflection and conversation. I don't want to be a one-sided discussion. May Allah show us mercy. And may He give us mercy. And may He allow us to translate that mercy toward one another. And may Allah forgive us. And may He allow us to be people who He saved from the hellfire. Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Arhamar Rahimin. Ya Arhamar Rahimin. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد